I'm Bruce Dominguez, and I've been working in the rapid prototyping community for over the past 10 years. Right now, I've been developing a project utilizing 3D printing, CNC milling, and traditional mold making techniques, and bringing them all together utilizing inexpensive desktop injection molding for a project that I call Call to Adventure. It's kind of a product of being inspired by the Mold-A-Rama, like a little plastic injection molded machines that you could find. The instant gratification you can get when you put your coins in and it shoots it out, it's still hot in your hands. You see the advent of 3D printing that's exploded. It's so common that kids in grade schools are 3D printing. For me, my idea is injection molding is the next plateau. Like, that's the one that's on the horizon. And you're using real materials. They could be food safe. I believe it's like the next big kind of thing to come up. So being a maker is kind of like actually coming up with solving my own problems, but taking that and communicating them to other people so they can avoid some of the pitfalls that I went through figuring out how to do it correctly. And that is kind of where I see the maker community being the penultimate of collaboration. What I hope people come in when they come through the Maker Faire and they see all these different types of projects going on, that it'll spark their curiosity and plant the seed of seeing that, you know, there is a community of people kind of already working on something that you might be interested in, and that you'll be able to go and reach out, and people will be more than happy to be able to collaborate and tell you how things are made, what they're doing with them. There's always going to be a community of people who have to share what they're doing, and that will never go away. And I see that younger kids are getting involved more in it, and it won't be a niche thing anymore. Everyone, or a majority of people, will be makers. There'll be garages that are filled with workshops, and the cars parked out in the front yard. I think more and more people will actually, I won't say identify as makers, they'll be them, and they won't realize it.